Wireless carriers in the U.S. shrink from 4 to 3 with a big merger, and sugar and artificial colors making a comeback in cereal. Jane King is live at the NASDAQ with those stories. Good morning, Jane.
Hey, Melissa. Good morning to you. Yes, it is official. T-Mobile and Sprint are merging to form a $146 billion new company. They plan to take on Verizon and AT&T. So new technology, stiff competition, that is all forcing these companies to get together. And together, they will have about 127 million customers. Now, some analysts do say this merger could mean the end of Sprint's low-cost alternative plan. Well, Southwest has its first lawsuit over the failed engine incident. A passenger who survived says she is suffering from anxiety and post-traumatic stress disorder. Southwest nor the other aerospace companies named in the suit responded. Well, Subaru says some employees manipulated fuel economy data. This is the latest revelation in an ongoing investigation of faulty inspections at the car maker. All of the cars in question were made in Japan. Subaru says it's not sure how long this went on, but top executives were not aware of it. And after years of what some call health washing, there seems to be a move back to an artificially brighter, more colorful, and certainly sweeter bowl of cereal. The Wall Street Journal reports cereal sales have fallen about 11% over the last 5 years as companies have gone healthier. So General Mills, their sales have been up a little bit. They brought Frosted Flakes, also peanut butter, chocolate Cheerios back. Oreo O's from Post have been returned to shelves as well. And a study finds Google Assistant is smarter than Alexa. But it also found Amazon's assistant, Alexa, is getting smarter. Stone Temple found that Google Assistant attempts the most responses and gets the most attempted responses correct. And a Blue Origin test flight means rockets are closer to launching people. A new Shepard booster took off from a launch pad in West Texas and briefly flew into space with an instrumented capsule and returned to a rocket-assisted landing yesterday in another test before humans can climb aboard the suborbital spaceship. Okay, stocks hit in mixed on Friday. The NASDAQ was up just slightly. The tech giants Amazon and Microsoft hit record highs. The broader markets, however, closed just barely changed. Looks like we might open about 100 points higher today. Live in the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King for Fox 8 News. Melissa, back to you.
Jane, I was just looking at that Blue Origin test flight. That is something, are you saving up? Is that something you want to take into space?
You know, I do not know if there's a price on this yet, and I imagine they're going to have to do many more before they allow people on there, but I don't know. I might. I'll let some other people do it first, though.
Yeah, I'm going to let thousands and thousands of people do it first.
It's on the bucket list.
Yes.
Could be interesting.
Yes, a bucket list many years in the future, but it is. It's cool to see all of this happening, and one day we know it will.
That's right.
Jane, thanks so much. Have a great day.
Okay, thanks.
One part of the